Truck drivers are on the front lines of the pandemic, facing lower pay these days and higher risks as they deliver much-needed food and supplies. Tonight's Brief But Spectacular features Kansas City-based husband and wife truckers, Chante and Ron Drew. After Ron began experiencing symptoms of COVID-19 last month, producer Steve Goldblum conducted a series of interviews with the couple over the course of several weeks.
Ron and I are a married couple. We drive team freight across the country. We haul a lot of groceries, a lot of produce, a lot of meats, things like that.
Truck drivers, we've always been kind of like, you know, we don't get a lot of respect. We're kind of looked down upon, but people saw how crazy things got when the toilet paper ran out. Can you imagine if you go to the grocery store and there's no food in there? I don't know why they're not making more of an effort to get personal equipment for drivers. You need us to run so you can have food. We've got two beds. The bottom bed we leave is a table, so we have some place to sit and eat.
When I'm driving, he's sleeping, and when he's sleeping, I'm driving.
I first started experiencing symptoms when I was in Phoenix last week. Mostly like body aches, hurting my knees, hurting my elbows. My fever would just spike, and I just start just aching and aching.
Hot, cold chills.
Hot, cold chills. But I trooped it out, got her done.
And then we just went today to get his test finally.
You have your crack your window down, and then they just squeeze you your sinuses.
I figured since if Ron's positive, obviously I'll be positive as well. So we figure save the testing for somebody else. We both got it probably.
Hopefully we'll know by Wednesday at the latest. I feel horrible. Since Saturday, I've not been able to get really out of bed for anything. I've dropped about 30 pounds. I've never experienced anything like this where you sleep constantly.
We got Ron's COVID test back and it was positive. I opted at first not to get tested. I figured, you know, I'm probably positive, but then after talking to the nurse, she said it's probably a good idea to go ahead and get tested. I'm not showing too many symptoms other than just being extremely fatigued. I'm pretty sure that I'll test positive. We've been in contact with the company that we are leasing a truck from, and they've suspended our truck payments for as long as needed. We're probably gonna go lay down right now and, you know, just rest and recover and hope and pray that nobody else has to go through this. I was tested for COVID. I tested negative. Our doctor and the health department both told us to go ahead and assume that I had it since I had all the same symptoms as Ron. The doctor told me that they're getting a lot of false negatives just with the way that a lot of the people are doing the swab testing, but we've been slowly recovering.
One morning you wake up, you feel great. You go outside, just do a couple things, and next thing you know, you're winded, you're in bed, you're sleeping again for 12 hours, you know, straight during the day. Almost 22 days we've been off work. We got turned on to a resource called St. Christopher's Fund, which is for truck drivers. And they ended up making our rent payment for the month.
That's huge.
Which helped a ton. Luckily for us, the company we drive for, they got freight right now.
I'm glad our first trip is going out to Seattle. It's always fun going out that way.
I just wanted to get back out and get moving.
Get the wind in your hair and get the dogs back out at the rest areas and do what we do best.
This thing is no joke. Like, your lung capacity doesn't come back up right away. You still can't taste or smell for God knows how long this is gonna be. I still get pain in my knees that I didn't have before. Just don't brush it off and thinking, oh, you know, 99% of us are gonna get well. Well, you're not gonna get 100% well.
My advice would be just to have compassion for each other and quit trying to hurry the process of getting back out there and getting back to work, because it'll happen. It's just, you gotta listen to the experts. Before the pandemic, I think a lot of people didn't realize where their food came from. We've heard friends that have seen signs that people are saying, you know, we love truck drivers. Truck drivers have never asked for hazard pay. You know, in fact, our rates have gone down since the pandemic started. So we're making less overall than when this first started. We just want to still be able to do our jobs. And I just hope that people don't forget about it as, you know, time goes on. My name is Chante Drew.
My name is Ron Drew.
And this is our brief but spectacular take on living through COVID-19.
And here at the NewsHour, we love truck drivers, and thank you, Chante and Ron. We're so glad you're better. And you can find all of our brief but spectacular segments online at pbs.org/newshour/brief.